Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Once again, I am with someone who is not husky. It's none other than Mr. Bitter.
Yeah.
Now, I know you love him. Let's give a round of applause to Mr. Bitter.
Well, thank you, Sean. I had no idea I was going to be here today. I knew I was going to be here, but not up here.
And in fact, I specifically brought you up here with little information because I honestly think that it will deliver a better punch.
Okay.
When we get to, we get to the next
thing. I'm incredibly nervous because I don't...
Well, let's start with something that I think is fairly normal.
Okay.
I just want to ask you, how did you get your start? Because right now you work as caster full-time over at NASL.
That's correct.
But what was going on when you first started getting into the esports space?
Like so many of the other, I guess, successful esports personalities, I was just a nerd in my room that said, hey, I really like this game. I'm going to create some content around this game, and I never really expecting it to take off. But it did. So I did a little show with Jeff and Control Robinson called 12 Weeks with the Pros. Pro came on, coached me. People were able to watch and learn and follow my progress as well. And it was wildly successful for some reason. And that
dude, it was awesome. I watched 12 Weeks with the Pros.
Oh, stop it.
I did. I would not lie about that. That would be weird. Be like, I watched it. I don't know what happened.
Yeah,
so it sounds cool.
I enough people watched it that I was offered a job in Germany, and I flew to Germany, worked at ESL for about a year, and now I'm here working at the North American Star League, and it's just awesome. So
yeah.
Living the esports life. It's pretty great.
Now, let me cut to exactly why I wanted to bring you here with your amazing diction.
Oh, God.
Now, we did a little bit of poem reading with Kevin Nock earlier.
Okay.
Again, it was part of the contest for submission for this event over on TeamLiquid.net. And we also had a general fan fiction submission one.
Oh.
So there's two winners, and I would like to read one that I have face up, and you have one face down. And I would like, after I'm done with my story, that you flip it over and you just...
Just jump right in.
You just read it. So... Without any further ado, StarCraft fan fiction. Now, of course, I want to note that many of you watching are fans of StarCraft as an esport, following the tournaments, following the competitive scene. But it's also true there is a huge number who love the lore of the game, who have been so excited to see the new cinematics coming out for Heart of the Swarm. I'm definitely one of those lore nerds as well. So I would like to begin as an ode to the StarCraft lore community. Let's zoom in like a Ken Burns documentary. This is from J-Care, It Must Be Tuesday. It was finally morning. A ray of light entered through the cracks on the walls. Private Cross woke up with the light hitting his eyes. He turned around, trying to get a few more minutes of sleep, and the barracks shook. Something must have hit it pretty hard. He stood up and looked around. Another of his brothers was also waking up. He decided to go to the bathroom. He had to take a leak. He took his sweet time. He thought he really shouldn't have drunk so much, but then again, he didn't believe he could make it to the next day without a couple of cold ones. It didn't matter anyways. He then went to the sink. Cold water was the best way for a man to wash himself and get ready for the following day. The barracks shook again. It didn't matter. He dipped his hands in the water and took them to his face. It felt good. He did it again. He stared into the mirror in front of him and saw himself. The barracks shook again. It didn't matter. He left the bathroom. More of his brothers were waking up. Some were already standing. Others were still rolling around on their bunks. Someone seemed to whistle some kind of tune, but most were silent, getting mentally ready for the hardships of the day ahead. Cross left the sleeping area and went into the gearing section. He stepped on the platform, and soon enough, a veritable army of robot arms appeared around him. He looked around. Another one of his brothers was also in the room. The arms began moving, slowly connecting his armor around him. First his legs, then his torso, and his arms, finally his helmet. The barracks shook again. It still didn't matter. Both men stepped out onto the platform and grabbed their trusty Gauss rifles. Their shift was about to begin. The door opened and they stepped outside. Ash fell from the sky. Lava flowed in the back and the ground shook under their feet. The typical char welcome. Machine gun fire was heard coming from just further ahead and the siege tanks were shooting into the distance. Finally, you grunts have decided to appear, shouted the commander, sitting on top of the nearest tank. Get your asses down there. The Zerg are pushing heavily on our position and we need every gun we can. Upon hearing this, Private Cross stared back at his fellow Marine and said, It must be Tuesday. Yeah! I think that is awesome. I love that piece. I actually, round of applause for J-Care for busting that one out. Because honestly, you know, again, it's so easy to fall into that esports trap and to just view it just as the mechanics of the game, how do you get ahead, how do you win, and that sort
of
thing.
So much more.
And then with the single-player campaign, StarCraft II, original single-player, amazing, super excited for Heart of the Swarm. I just love this depiction of the life of a Marine.
So now I'm up?
Now it's your turn, Mr. Bitter.
All right, let's do this.
Can we get a slow, nice shot of Mr. Bitter? I'm excited. Here it comes.
This is called Hungry Cerberus. He is a tiny man, inside and out, his face perpetually turned downwards, as if to avoid meeting the gaze of those whom he considers lesser, which seems to include everyone. He wears glasses, dark-rimmed and piercing, magnifying his beady glaze. His chin is wrapped in a dark strap of hair that grows in ordered rows, conforming to his rigid desire, his need to control. It's only hair, but on him it is violence, and an extension of his snarl, an accent that draws the eye downwards into his downcast expression, pulling your focus to the feature he unleashes upon you, dark, dread eyes. His name is Idra. And he probably hates you. The other's face is soft and boyish, black hair short, straight, and perfectly balanced. His face is heart-shaped, if that is possible, if only because his queer eyebrows are built in taut diagonals toward his nose, and his ears are large, permanently covered by a dark hoodie, blocking out the world, leaving only room for the game. He smiles often, and with the slight curve of a man who has reason to be smug. He holds his hands together, outstretched in front of him, as if they are a talisman to ward off the approaching dark, as if his heart is being held carefully in front of him, daring the world to take it. Huck stares straight ahead, forever ready to meet his destiny. The two men sit together, ignoring each other, words having lost any meaning. In front of them sits a wasteland, the battered remnants of their dreams, their lives. The world they have built sits in ruin. A vast empire once stood here, one built on growth and control, massive armies carefully organized and orchestrated, each detail in place. The second was built on brazen and courageous fury, attacks in the face of danger, long shots, and against the odds, all or nothing, a confidence built on wit and intelligence, two vastly different empires, but built as if there could be no end. But the empires have fallen, leaving nothing but wastes. They have returned here to begin anew, ignoring the losses and the sharp edge of doubt. They sit together, staring at the nothingness with only hope and a promise. They are the fallen giants, the beasts among men who will tear the world into two halves, bearing the sigils of the black and red heart. They are the evil geniuses, the tyrants, the conquerors of men, and they have nothing for now. Beware the fall of giants, and above all, beware their return.
I want him to write my resume.
I have no idea who wrote this. There's not a name on the page.
There's Hungry Cerberus at the top.
Oh, that's who? That's not the name?
No.
Okay, I thought the title was Hungry Cerberus.
Actually, huge round of applause for Hungry Cerberus for writing such an awesome piece about Idra and Huck. Because, you know, so many people have such enthusiasm for their favorite pros.
I love the depiction of Idra. Dark, dead eyes.
A chin strap. Representing violence.
And he probably hates you.
Yeah, that was written. That wasn't you. You looked at the camera as though you said that, but that was on the page.
Yes, it was.
Awesome. You know, I will say, I feel like I like these two pieces quite a bit just due to the fact that it's lore and esports, really two of the big hearts of the upcoming Heart of the Swarm expansion that we're all so pumped about. So without any further ado, I'm going to throw to one of our final video segments tonight. You may have seen it at the start of the day. You may have been following this documentary from its early inception. Star Nation is on its final stretch, and here is a teaser trailer of what's to come. Stay tuned.